basically they don't give anything away. It's as simple as that. They're very well organised. They've got a tremendous back four. And they're so compact as a team. It's going to be hard to break them down, but it's down to us to do it with a home side.
Also facing old friends, Vinny Jones fighting Chelsea's corner against the Sheffield United men, who were his teammates this time last week. Brief highlights from Bramall Lane.
It's an unchanged Leeds team from the one which gained a point at Old Trafford on Saturday. So John Lukic continues his amazing run of 4.5 years without missing a league game for first Arsenal and now Leeds. Mel Sterling starts a home match for the first time this season. And David Weatherall, the centre-back who played for England in the World Student Games, is on the bench and hoping to make a league debut. Gary Speed has come on a pace since his introduction to the side and yesterday signed a new contract which will keep him at Elland Road for the next 4 years. Arsenal boss George Graham has lost his wingman Anders Limpar, scorer of 2 goals in this corresponding fixture last year, because he's on international duty for Sweden against Yugoslavia, and David O'Leary replaces David Rowcastle. Our official this evening is from West Kirby on the Whittle. He's Bob Nixon. The last time he was here towards the end of last season, Leeds lost at home to Crystal Palace. And Leeds begin attacking the Kop. Arsenal are in the gaudy new strip. That's the only way I think we can describe it. And of course, regular visitors to this ground last season. The sides met on 6 occasions, 4 times in the FA Cup. And Arsenal didn't lose on any of those occasions. They drew here 2-2 in the league. And Leeds looking, first of all, through Chapman with the back heel. And now Sterling. Not sure they will go out of play for a Leeds throw-in. And they have Mel Sterling back in the side to execute the longer throw-ins if they choose. Strachan cutting it back to McAllister, over the top of it he goes. Rodney Wallace gets the shot in on target, and although the linesman raised the flag, referee waved play on. Rodney Wallace still looking for his first goal for Leeds, of course, since his move from Southampton. And the battle this time between Smith and White produces the free kick for Arsenal, which will be taken by perhaps Paul Davis. Really have to say, these are the worst numbers I think I've ever seen in football. The red doesn't stand out at all. Right in a close-up, but it's very difficult, I can tell you, from the gantry position. So I can tell you it was Dixon and then Davis. And the ball is pumped up there towards Linegan. But Strachan clears. And that was Dixon going across, and he's onside here. Paul Merson can give Arsenal the lead. And it's cut right across the face of goal, put behind by Dorigo. And a really wasted opportunity then for Arsenal. Dorigo putting the ball out of play, but Merson had broken the offside trap, went around Lukic. Sterling had come back to cover, but Dorigo it was who put the ball out. Campbell unable to convert. So an Arsenal corner. They have a lot of big men in there, but Leeds have McAllister to nod it out. Wallace looking to break for Leeds. Hitting the ball long, and Strachan will chase, but Seaman's there first. Might have to put it out as well. Plays it straight to Strachan. Chapman calling for it quickly in the middle. He's got to deliver it sharply though, and tried to curve it in. Well, it really wasn't very good goalkeeping that by David Seaman. He'd been better advised to put the ball out of play. There was always the chance of a ricochet, and Strachan putting it over the top. And Smith gives chase, and again they catch Leeds out here. Smith, once more, the long leg of Chris White comes to the aid of Leeds United. He's had a magnificent start to the match as Chris White, and by all accounts he was one of the top performers at Old Trafford on Saturday. Lee Dixon. That's long, and the back header wasn't bad either, and Lukic, under some pressure, has to turn the ball behind. Campbell's coming in on him. And corner given, but the referee has now gone over to the linesman on the far side, and having spoken to him, changes the verdict. And Leeds get a free kick, maybe even a goal kick. It's a bit unsure though, because it's directly on the 6-yard line. Got through as far as Wallace, and now McAllister nicks it further to Chapman. Dorigo this time, not a good ball. Linegan able to cut it out. Wallace is only a little fella, but he got there, and now Chapman takes it on under pressure from Linegan, and he's done really well. Chapman, and swerves the shot in, no more than a couple of feet wide. And those are the battling qualities of Lee Chapman that are appreciated by the Elland Road fans. He and Linegan in an almighty tussle, a real battle of heavyweights. Chapman came off best. He beat Seaman, but it went wide. Paul Davis. It's going nowhere, unless the Lions was going to get involved. And after 18 minutes, it's Leeds nil, Arsenal nil. Leeds in possession, with Dorigo sprightly. Batty calling for it short. Here he is, David Batty might try his luck. Be disappointed not to have hit the target. A well-known fact that he doesn't score goals, and I'm sure it's a record he wants to put straight. And I think he's waving to the cop there, because they were cheering the fact he had a strike on goal. Must be a foul by Stirland, having lost the possession. He then took it out on his man Campbell. Merson always looks dangerous, and Arsenal with plenty of men up in this attack. Dangerous cross here, and they could be in trouble, and Leeds indeed were in trouble. Beautifully struck by Alan Smith. And Arsenal have the lead on 20 minutes. Alan Smith's fourth goal of the season. Winterburn cut it back, and Smith, with one sweep of the left foot, beat Lukic comprehensively. Arsenal had a lot of men forward. Smith could hardly have struck it better. 20 minutes gone. It's Leeds nil, Arsenal 1. What a great start he's had to the campaign. Good leader, Tony Adams. Good talker in the game as well. He keeps the rest on their toes. And Linegan, playing a dangerous game, eventually gives it away to a white shirt. It was Dorigo, and now Wallace. Not afraid to take them on, Rodney Wallace, but it's going to be no more than a throw-in for Leeds. Sure, it will lift so much of the pressure for him when he puts the ball in the net for the first time. Batty's long throw, headed straight on. Wallace came for it, McAllister against the legs of the defender. Comes away to Strachan, back in. And I think it was Merson's head that got in the way that time. No, in fact, Merson's up there, so... It was Dixon, in fact. Oh, well won by McClelland as well, and he gives the ball for Batty. Wallace calling for it up the middle. Dorigo makes a forward run, keeps going too, but nothing at the end of it. Oh. That is long throw in there, and it created a scramble with that flick back. McAllister trying to get the shot in, and Arsenal just got bodies in the way. Campbell. Sterling stretching, winning it. Batty. Chapman's layoff is for speed. Good sweeping move this from Leeds, and Dorigo involved. Cross it comes into the area, Chapman's still there, can't get his toe end on it, but Batty will pick it up now. Oh, there's appeal for a handball, but it was against the chest of Andy Linegan. And Arsenal come away unscathed again. Smith for Arsenal, cutting it back, and more danger here. Campbell could make it two for Arsenal. Lukic put him off. John Lukic did really well there. Campbell, a mere nick of the outside of the boot, could have carried it over the Leeds line. But John Lukic just did enough to put him off, and in fact made the save with his left leg. Oh, and there Winterburn, having won the ball from Wallace, gave it back to him, and Wallace goes. That was Linegan who hoofed it away. One players are in Arsenal's half, and he's found speed inside the area. Gary Speed! Well, he really wellied that one, didn't he? But it flew over the top of the Arsenal crossbar. He wanted a corner, he didn't get one. Speed, who struck those two beauties at Southampton last week, looking to repeat his form at the Dell, on the left foot. Plenty of power in it, but too much elevation. Arsenal's manager, George Graham. Something to talk about at the moment. Stuart Houston is on his right. Leeds seek to play themselves into the Arsenal half again. Some neat skills you do have to admire the quality of the football, and Arsenal have shown several qualities there. And Michael Thomas is the man on the ball. It was McClelland who nudged it away, but it's back in towards Campbell, and a marvellous save from Lukic getting down to his left. Excellent stop by Lukic, he had to be so alert then. With Kevin Campbell, a powerful header of the ball, coming in to meet Dixon's cross. Well directed, and Lukic down to scramble it away. And half-time here at Elland Road then, it's Leeds United 0, Arsenal 1, Alan Smith scoring the goal on 20 minutes, a crisply struck shot with his left foot. So Leeds have a lot to do. I wonder what Howard Wilkinson's going to be saying to them in the dressing room. We can hear now from one of the Leeds United players not in action this evening, the injured Chris Fairclough. He's with Nick.
Chris, whatever the critics have been saying, Arsenal looked a pretty efficient machine tonight, haven't they?
Yeah, they've played some tremendous football tonight. They've played some fast football, and it's been very attractive, and it's caused us a few problems.
So what's the message from the Leeds bench about how you counter it in the second half?
Well, I think we'll carry on the way we're doing. It's probably just our final ball that's letting us down. We're playing some fast, furious football ourselves, and the passing is good. It's just in the last third where it's probably letting us down a little bit.
So you can come back?
I'm sure we can come back.
Thanks very much indeed, Chris.
Thank you.
Thank you, Nick. It's Leeds 0, Arsenal 1 at half-time. We'll have the second half for you after this break.